get besieged by the enemy, the Alabees were a central food source. So the belief was that the monkeys then were encouraged in greater number, brought in, and left on the rock as a food source. Because the monkeys far more intelligent than we are, so they decided that wasn't going to happen.
It worked out, maybe, that they were here as a food source. They didn't like that. My personal opinion was they turned around to the British and they said, you lot end up brawling with everybody that you seem to meet in Europe and the rest of the world, and you're not taking our great aunt Sophie, chucking her in a casserole pot, bombarding with carrots, drowning her with gravy and eating her. You're not having it. So pin back your ears. You're gullible, you're animal lovers. We reckon we can sell you the story. We the monkey now symbolise the sovereignty of the British on the Rock of Gibraltar. If you touch one of us by your own hand, you will lose the Rock of Gibraltar. And we continue to believe that. And they hate noise and disturbance, and it stresses them. Now, we wouldn't be up on this rock if it was filled with 300 baboons or picked up axes. They're just nasty. Our monkeys are very benign. Because of that, they are very badly affected by change and stress, which is why they stay up here and let us live down there in that horrible jungle. But during the Second World War, they got so badly stressed, devastating effect on the morale of the troops here. And Churchill allowed the RAF to go over to Tangier, beg, steal and borrow 24 new monkeys, brought them in to Gibraltar. Now the Vichy French were holding Tangier, and they were licking the boots of the Nazis. So we nicked the monkeys right under the Nazi radar and pumped up our
win the war. But to make sure we keep stocks at a decent level, from now on, every monkey is to be registered, tattooed, named and identified on the Rock of Gibraltar. That has continued ever since, and every single monkey has its own individual name, and the primatologist can identify all of them.
Thank you.
gorgeous. No, not that side of you, please. Thank you very much. They've got a 5.5 month gestation period, and the babies are all born in the summer months. Lifespan between 19 and 22 years is average, but the same is
very much pinned on the rock. Therefore, we've got a moral and an ethical obligation to make sure these monkeys live decent. A small drop of food every day. 5% of the monkeys nibbles. They choose a vegetarian diet. The whole rock is loaded with olive trees. But God and nature played a mean game. Right. Slightly worrying that monkey eyeing up the contents of the taxi. Even today we have a ceremony of the keys where our governor ceremoniously locks the Rock of Gibraltar, battens it down, and right up through the Victorian era. Would you leave that alone? He's only just bought it. And he's not going to do you any good at all.
There we go. No, you see?
He thinks it's plastic. He'll go for it. Serialised and named. That has continued ever since. The primatologists, the first monkey named was Winnie, the second one was Ike, and because the military looked after them until 1965, in 1944 somebody thought it would be howlingly funny to call one of the monkeys Adolf. We had two monkeys born 2 years ago, and we called them Diamond and Jubilee. We got Charles and Camilla, we got Elizabeth and Philip, we got Kate and William and George already. Now this is where we are at our thinnest. We are literally half a mile. There's actually a tunnel that runs from the old naval dockyard right through the rock.
The older monks won't go near the side. They're terrified you might use it as a weapon on them. But the youngsters have yet to learn that harsh lesson. They haven't been clobbered by somebody. But they are incredibly gentle.
They're ever so easy going. Right, carry on walking down. Scotland. I like to say it was the monkeys that voted yes in the red. Been brutally attacked, absolutely dead.
devastated inside, but there was a good reason for that. During the Second World War, we thought we were going to get hammered. We watched our big boy cousin Malta receive more Nazi bombs than any other territory from Nazi Germany throughout the entire Second World War. And we thought we were going to get exactly the same treatment.
As a bomb-proof auxiliary field hospital, and the Royal Engineers were given free license to come in here with sledgehammers, and they just cleared everything that was in the way, apart from the big taper.
And we did put in the ultimate rock theatre, but I don't think anyway, we're not destroying this game just to give you a backdrop of the sound of the theatre play.
Governor is General Sir Jim Dutton, Royal Marine, which is only fitting because the Marine Corps took the Rock of Gibraltar in 1704 for England and Queen Anne. But main religion here in Gibraltar is Catholicism because of all the Italian blood.